I'm here to show you the new NotebookLM and show you 5 more ways to supercharge your life with it. I'm pretty sure number 5 is gonna blow your mind, so let's get into it. Now, NotebookLM is a tool you can use for free with a Google account. To access it, go to the following website. You can click the card in the top right or click on the link I've included in the description below. From the home screen, click the giant button that says Try NotebookLM. Before we get started, it's important to note that your personal data is never used to train or improve NotebookLM. Let's click OK to continue. And we're here on the NotebookLM start page. I'm going to walk you through all of this step by step, so don't worry about missing out. Go ahead and click Create. Here, we'll create our first notebook, and we'll use it to create a great YouTube video. In fact, I'm going to show you what I did to create this video. Now we start with this upload sources pane. Every notebook needs sources to reason over. Those sources make up the core knowledge of the AI of the notebook. What that means is anything you upload here, you can ask the AI about. There are multiple types of sources. The most prominent are Google Docs, Google Slides, websites, YouTube videos, and raw text. You can also upload PDFs, text files, markdown files, or even MP3 audio files. Let me show you how this works. We'll click on the YouTube button to upload a YouTube video. I'll click on the YouTube URL box, and then I'll paste a video link, which I'll explain in just a moment. Finally, I'll click Insert to add the source. And in a few seconds, we've just entered the heart of our notebook. And what is this video that I linked to? You can click on any source in the Sources pane on the left-hand side of the screen to get its details. For YouTube videos, you'll get a quick summary of the transcript of the content. You can watch the video, and if you scroll down, you'll get the transcript of the video. And if you need to see more of it, you can collapse the source guide up above by clicking on the blue arrow. You probably noticed that the main chat pane also summarized this video. At this point, you can start asking your notebook questions through chat. I'll put my cursor down in the chat box below, and I'll ask the question, how do I create a pivot table? Then I can press enter or click the blue arrow to submit. Let's collapse the sources pane so we have more breathing room. Click the pinching icon in the top right of the sources view to close this source. Then click the sidebar icon to collapse the source panel entirely. And here we see the result, based solely on the information that Kevin provided in the video. Now you probably notice some of these gray circles with numbers in them. These are references to content in your sources. And if you click on one, you're taken directly to that source material. Now you've got the lay of the land here. Let me show you what we're gonna do with this video. You see, this is one of Kevin's most liked videos. And I wanna create more videos like Kevin because he's my hero. So give me a couple seconds to add the rest of his videos so that NotebookLM can teach me how to make videos like Kevin. Now I've got 10 videos to learn from. Here's what I'm gonna ask NotebookLM. The sources include Kevin's most well-liked videos. List the principles that Kevin uses to make these great videos so I can make a new video about NotebookLM in the same style. Break the principles up into the intro, tutorial content, and outro. We'll hit the blue arrow and wait for our response. Let's click the sidebar icon on the studio pane this time so that we can see more of the response. And let's scroll up to intro principles. And here we see some of the ideas that make Kevin's videos great, like clearly stating the topic and learning objective immediately, highlighting the value proposition up front, and speaking about how to get the tool for the tutorial. And just like before, we have references in the gray circles. Now, I'm not gonna scroll down and reveal all of Kevin's secrets, so I'll leave that as an exercise for you at home. For this next example, you're in for a real treat, because this is how I personally use NotebookLM in my life. See, I'm having my first child in a couple months, so I'm taking this course on how to raise children who thrive. It's a series of lectures which I've uploaded to NotebookLM, because if you remember, when you add a source, you can choose to upload audio. Now, my job in taking this course is to learn the big concepts so I can call upon them when I need them. And learning itself can take many shapes and forms. So let me take you to the studio panel again and show you some cool things. Down in this notes pane, I can generate four different types of summaries. The briefing doc is an integrated paragraph by paragraph summary of all of the source content. An FAQ changes that summary into a series of questions and answers. The timeline organizes the source content by date and lays it out in a chronological order. And finally, the study guide gives you short answer and essay questions that test your knowledge. So I told you that I'm here to learn things. Let's see what the study guide creates for us. It takes about a minute to generate. Let's click it and see what's inside. As you can see, the study guide includes key ideas, and when you scroll down, you can see quiz questions. I've seen it create about 10 questions, and then it gives you an answer key down below. If you keep scrolling down, you'll find more thought-provoking questions posed as essay questions. Finally, you'll get a list of key terms at the bottom of the study guide. Are you ready to take this one step further? Let's close these two panels so that we can focus on the chat window. Here's a new prompt to take this out of the theoretical. Provide 10 real-world challenging scenarios with children based mostly on the content in these lectures that my wife and I can use to discuss and shape how we parent. And then after all the scenarios, add an answer key. Let's click the arrow and see what happens. And in 30 seconds, we've got our result. Let's see what scenarios it put together for us. Take a second to pause the video and look at some of these scenarios. Regardless of how you personally feel about them, using prompts like this is a proven way to take learning from being passive to actually engaging your imagination. Before we move on, I want you to take special care. Your chat history is not saved, so if you want to save a chat response, you need to scroll to the bottom of that response and then click on Save to Note. All of these notes appear in the studio panel, like the study guide we created earlier. We're back in the same lecture series on how to raise children who thrive. This time, instead of texting with NotebookLM, we're going to talk with it. To do this, let me direct your attention to the audio overview section of the studio panel. This is where we can create and customize a podcast covering any of the source material. Now, if you click generate, the podcast will have two hosts talking about some part of the content. But we're going to do something a little more fun. Let's click the customize button. NotebookLM suggests we can focus on a specific source or a specific topic or a specific audience, but you and I are not going to do any of those things. Instead, we are going to ask NotebookLM to pretend that one of the hosts is actually the lecturer who delivered these courses. Now let's click generate and wait a few minutes for the podcast to be created. Now we've got a 32-minute podcast, and don't worry, I'm not going to make you listen to all of it, but let's check out a few seconds so you get an idea of what it's all about. So I'll take you a little bit past the intro and then hit start.
In that way.
Well, get ready because we're taking a deep dive today into the science of how kids learn and grow.
It should be fun.
And to guide us, we've got an expert in child development, Dr. Peter Vishton.
Thanks for having me.
Now, one of the things that really stood out from your research is this idea that babies aren't just blank slates.
Right.
So not only do we get a podcast summary of the course, but we also get to hear it from AI Dr. Vishton. So the new version of NotebookLM has added this interactive mode button, which I know you've wanted me to press for the last 2 minutes. In this mode, we get to talk to the podcast host directly. Let's click it and try it. To get started, you hit the play button down below. And then when the podcast starts playing, you can ask a question by clicking the join button. Let's give it a shot.
And to guide us, we've got an expert in child development, Dr. Peter Vishton.
Thanks for having me.
Oh, our listeners got something to share. Let's hear it.
Dr. Vishton, at what age should we start teaching our kids how to read?
That's a great question, and it's one that a lot of parents wonder about.
It really highlights our desire to help our kids get a head start.
It's interesting because while we all want our kids to succeed, it may be too early to focus on reading at such young ages.
Right, and we've seen in the research that it's more important to nurture the love of language and learning first.
Absolutely.
Now, I paused this off camera before it got too far, but I hope you start to see the real power of this technology. So we've got you inspired to create a new YouTube video. We've sped up how fast you learn. And now we've got you talking with your course lecturers. So let's move on to number 4, making sense of your handwritten notes. To do this, we're going to create a new notebook. I'll move my mouse to the top left and click on the NotebookLM icon. Then I'll click the Create New button to create a new notebook. And now we're back in familiar territory. Now, several years ago, I took these notes on a book called Continuous Discovery Habits. As you can see, I organized concepts visually as opposed to in paragraph form. And I exported this as a PDF from my Remarkable tablet. And by the way, if you want me to do a video on my experience with the Remarkable, let me know in the comments. Anyway, it's been several years since I looked at these notes, so let's see what we can do with them inside NotebookLM. These notes are in PDF format, so I'll drag them in. Now, I could create a study guide like last time to help me get up to speed, but I'm more interested in taking action. So, here's my prompt. What is one thing that I can teach tomorrow to my whole team to start nudging them towards the continuous discovery model? And just like before, I get suggestions directly from the input, which even includes references. I promise you I have saved the best for last, and we're gonna need two tools, both NotebookLM and ChatGPT. We'll start with ChatGPT. Now, it used to be that some of us had good role models and some of us didn't, and that's just the way the cookie crumbled. But with AI, we can breathe new life into historical or even fictional figures and turn them into role models, or even better yet, into advisors to give us advice when we're contemplating life's hard questions. So buckle up, I'm gonna type in a wild prompt here. So for each of the following people, generate a profile that would give an AI enough information to impersonate that profile and give advice from their point of view. So I've got my cast of historical, contemporary, and even fictional characters that I'd like to ask advice from. The prompt's ready, let's make it fly. Now that we've got our list of profiles, I'm going to select all of them. I'll copy them with Control C. Then I'll go back to NotebookLM and click on Copy Text to use it as a source. Then I'll click on the text box and press Control V to paste. I'll click Insert and that commits our source. Now here's what I want to ask. Treat each of the personas described in the sources as its own person on my personal board of advisors. Respond as each advisor giving me advice on the following question. How should I balance meaningful work and raising children? Let's see how far the rabbit hole goes. Looking at this, we've got a lot of advice from our board of advisors. I strongly encourage you to try this for yourself, because all you need is one statement from one of these advisors to possibly change the course of your life. That's powerful stuff. And a quick look at how NotebookLM can enhance every aspect of your learning. Now, is this going to make you a superhuman? Let me know down in the comments. Check out our last NotebookLM video in the top right for some more inspiration, and please consider subscribing. I'll see you in the next video.